With the demolition of the Stardust Hotel and Casino, famed illusionist Rick Thomas and his Majestic Tigers found themselves forced out of Las Vegas. Now, after years away from the Strip, Rick is determined to make the biggest comeback of his career. Can this control freak of a boss, single father of four, and owner of six Bengal Tigers find the perfect venue for his new $50 million stage show? Will he win back his once loyal fans and finally fulfill his dream of becoming the greatest illusionist to ever hit the Las Vegas Strip? Find out this season on 9 Lives Las Vegas, Living and Working with Tigers.
Hi, I'm illusionist Rick Thomas. Welcome to my life, my home, family, cast, crew, tigers, you name it, you're part of it. I'd like to make myself believe the planet Earth turns slowly. Tonight is a very important night for me and my crew. We're having a huge PR event for the NSPCA, but first, I gotta go feed my tigers.
No matter how trained they are, no matter how much we work with these animals, no matter what, when it comes to feeding, if you are going into their cage, your food too. So, we leave them alone when they're eating.
It's about lunchtime, and I promised to take my kids out to lunch today, and we're gonna have a little fun as well.
Look at Michaela.
Side over here, guys.
Follow that car. That's it, boy. You're going the wrong way, sweetheart. You gotta turn around, you're going the wrong way. Isn't that funny? You hit the wall 61 times.
Holy crap!
You have to drive faster.
This is what we do. I do my show, and then I take my kids on the roller coaster.
Yeah.
Are you ready, buddy? Yeah! Let's go, we got a show to do. I love my kids, and I could play with them all day. But right now, I have a huge event, and I gotta get these cats ready.
Let's go for a walk, chill out. Can you put on the back of them and brush out the shampoo?
So this is Dawn.
Yeah, come here.
Before she brought in Darlene, she was my assistant handler. She brings with her New York attitude. She gets under everybody's skin, including mine. There was a time where Dawn needed to take care of some family matters, and she brought Darlene in, and she was amazing. She helped me just as Dawn did, and she was a people person.
I feel a little stabbed in the back. As a friend, if I were in that situation, I would have gone to the friend and said, how do you feel about this? Whereas instead, I had to go to Rick and say, I will step back as your primary handler because I wanted to keep the peace.
Watch it. Okay. Victorious!
Come on, boy.
I always love driving the trailer around because nobody knows we have tigers inside.
Richard is the head carpenter. He takes care of all the technical problems of the show.
Good morning, sunshine. Yeah, get this, it's a stinky face.
That's worse than stinky face.
He is a wonderful, humble man.
The strangest things happen when you're standing on a deck and you're a stagehand and you're looking around and here comes a tiger walking by you like a big dog.
Hi, I'm Rick Thomas, control freak. I have a problem.
Okay, I don't want you to follow crescendo of the music. I want you to follow me. At that point, you look at me.
Nobody can do my show but me. I do the videos.
I have seven tigers I've raised from birth.
The graphics, the music, the illusions. I even okay the dancers' costumes. I can drive you nuts.
By the way, in the opening on the birds, you are to be statues. No sticking tongues out, no making faces at each other. Stop it.
That's it. You get it away. Get it away.
I just thought you might want a little light when you ran off, but that's okay.
I think I look stupid.
The PR event at the NASCAR Cafe went better than I expected.
A lot of people have been looking at him. I'd love to adopt, but they all got rings on.
So let's talk about Joey. He's the lighting director of the show, and he makes the show look great.
Rick Thomas is the only friend I truly have in this world.
He also gets in everybody's business.
I am a very hard person. I'm my own worst enemy. I really need you to open your eyes and look at the whole picture and not just one thing. Some of the things I do, I have trouble sleeping a night over. Yeah, I do.
So you want me to be a dick to the crew?
Sometimes you gotta be.
Joey is the resident pain in the butt who's gotta find things to be a problem. I came on stage to help with crowd control and he,
get off the stage.
Off stage.
Honestly, pissed me off because he had no right to do that.
I can't stand her, man.
That's how he is with everybody. It's just what it is. Since I don't kiss butt, he's crotchety with me.
Without Joey, there'd be no headaches.
Joey, put it away.
That's
a bird for the show. I don't want him dead.
The show's about to start, but we have a few complications.
What time is it, and what are we looking at start time for a show?
People... It's 10 minutes to show time.
Yeah, it's 10 minutes to show time, but they're not going to have everybody see it.
Okay. He's going to find out right now if why they're even putting people up in the balcony if the bottom floor is not, it's not full yet. I don't know, man, but unless they have a full house downstairs, we need the people out of the balcony now. And we will hold the show until it's done.
There's nothing in the world that I wouldn't do for that man. I've never had a friend like him.
Being the control freak I am and trying to manage everything, the little things fall through the cracks.
Hey, Rick, we have a problem tonight.
What's the problem?
What are we going to do about Twister?
Well, who do we have in tonight?
Sarah's not here. You gave her the night off, and she does Twister.
Okay, I'll deal with it.
All the dancers are here. At least we have four dancers. I just had the wrong four dancers here. And in so doing, we had to pull out one, two, three effects out of the show. It's okay, though. That's what's cool about a magic show. The audience has no idea what we're going to do next. Neither do we.
We're grateful to be here celebrating the Nevada SPCA.
This character is Johnny. He's the show's producer, and if you give him 10 minutes, he'll sell you his home, his neighbor's home, and his brother's home. He is old school Vegas. He thinks jokes about tigers eating people is funny.
What's going on back here? Everyone leave, quick! The tigers are out!
I used to feed the tigers myself, and what? A couple of people do get eaten by the tigers every night.
That's not funny.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, Rick Thomas.
Hard!
Richard, where are you at right now?
Yeah, what do you need, bro?
Rick needs you on stage right now with the towel.
What? Are you kidding me?
He sent me out with a white towel.
Nice hand for our stage manager.
Take him out.
Do you not need that?
Nope.
Really stupid.
Joey, I need to talk to you.
Yeah, give me one sec.
I'll now.
I'm coming. I'll be there.
Before the show, we sit here and you talk about all these girls doing all this crap on stage, and we have a VIP event, sold out, most important night of all the nights, and you screw up just like they did. You hand Richard a cloth, he comes walking on stage, and what the hell was that?
You yelled at me on stage.
I don't care what I did.
Watch me next time.
I had a child that wasn't working, the lighting wasn't right, sound was horrible.
I take it very personal when he yells, I won't do it again, I'm sorry.
Let me help get you straight. You got the tigers, you have the cockatoos, you have the macaws, you have the doves, and you're gonna also meet Kitty.
This is Miss Kitty, and she's getting dressed for her part. You ready?
After receiving amazing reviews about my show last week, things are getting really exciting around here. I just may be moving to a larger hotel here in Las Vegas. And this morning, I just got great news that we're expecting a new addition to my family. Stay with me. Things are really starting to rock.